Hey, welcome to the channel. My name is Byron and I'm a traffic engineer living in the US. Today, I want to talk about the differences between a traffic engineer and a transportation engineer. While it's true that not all jobs are the same, there are some main differences you should know about. Before we get into that, we first have to talk about the transportation infrastructure timeline. When you look at any transportation infrastructure, for example, a road or a traffic signal, there are many phases it has to go through in order for it to get built and for it to last until the end of its life cycle. Here are some of the main phases. First, we have planning. This is before anything is built. This can be a lot of things, including high-level planning or studies. This can also be in the form of funding, for example, pursuing grants. Next, we have design. This is still before anything is actually built. Someone has to design the plans and specifications for the infrastructure that's going to be built, down to the smallest detail. After design, we have construction. This is when the project is built out in the field. It's self-explanatory. Anyone who's passing by can see it. But after the road and traffic signal is constructed, then what? There's still some phases left. Operations and maintenance is important in order to ensure the infrastructure reaches the end of its anticipated life cycle. Operations is making sure the infrastructure operates as intended. This can be things like timing the signal lights or analyzing collision patterns. We also have maintenance. Maintenance is the ongoing attention needed to ensure the infrastructure remains functional. This can be inspections, repairs, or replacements of parts that go bad. Let's now talk about where traffic and transportation engineers fit in. I'll start with what I know best, the role of a traffic engineer. As a traffic engineer who works in the government sector, I spend a lot of my time in the planning, operations, and maintenance roles. When it comes to our transportation network, a lot of planning needs to be done. Here are some examples of transportation planning that traffic engineers are typically involved in. We use computer modeling to determine future traffic demand on roadways. When new developments are built, we need to analyze the activity it will generate and ensure any needed infrastructure is in place. These are typically called traffic impact studies. We also can be involved in planning multimodal improvements that can accommodate all modes of transportation, including pedestrian, bicycle, and transit. Applying for grants is another one. Infrastructure is expensive, and applying for grants is another way government commonly funds projects. Some people may say these tasks are performed by transportation planners. That is true, but nowadays there's a lot of overlap between traffic engineers and transportation planners. At the moment, the time I spend at my job is about one-third transportation planning. That's a significant amount of time, but the main role of transportation has always been in operations. Here are some examples of that. Performing collision analysis and safety studies. Timing the traffic signals and modifying signal hardware. Keeping the speed limits up to date and current. Ensuring traffic signs and markings comply with the applicable standards. Managing neighborhood traffic calming programs and responding to citizen complaints. Collecting and monitoring traffic data and performance measures. The main difference with operations versus design and construction is it's ongoing and never really ends. So now let's talk about the role of a transportation engineer. So how's a transportation engineer different than a traffic engineer? Well, transportation engineer's work is likely to be more project-based. When there is a transportation project, an engineer is in charge of the design, construction, and delivery of that project. Transportation engineers work with many different specialists to ensure that their project is designed and constructed efficiently. Here are some examples of the coordination they have to do. They work with surveyors to map out and get accurate measurements of field conditions. They work with utility companies to ensure that all new utilities are included and that there are no conflicts. They work to secure right-of-way so that they can legally build their project on the property or public right-of-way. Transportation engineers can also be heavily involved with the design and construction of their project. Because of this, many transportation engineers often do CAD work at some point in their career. This allows them to produce plans for their project. Once the design is done, they are also involved with construction and making sure that the project is constructed to its design. Later in their careers, transportation engineers typically go on to manage projects as a project manager. It's also common to see transportation engineers overlap into transportation planning. I've seen this a lot as they can also help secure funding for their project through grants. In conclusion, even though there may be some similarities and overlap between traffic engineers and transportation engineers, there are also some main differences. Throughout the infrastructure timeline, you need both traffic engineers and transportation engineers to ensure that infrastructure is built and it remains safe and functional throughout its whole life cycle. But remember that reality is always not as clear cut. In the end, traffic engineers and transportation engineers are names and titles, and the duties associated with them are not always as rigid. And if you are one of them, it doesn't mean that you can't do a little bit of the other, or if you choose to transition to the other one later in your career. Sometimes there is overlap and you do have to know a little bit about other phases like design, construction, or operations. And lastly, just to make it a little more confusing, transportation planning can be covered by an actual transportation planner. And that's the difference between traffic engineers and transportation engineers. Thanks for watching this video, and I hope it helped you understand a little bit about what we do. Please like and subscribe if you'd like to see more of this type of content in the future. Feel free to leave a comment, or just say hi, or if you have any other additional questions. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.